Hello everyone, I am on the bed of infinite comforts to show some of the stuff that I got in the mail today. The first thing is... That was a good landing. By the way, it's not in focus. It is a micro B USB cable thingy because these suckers, for some reason, just keep breaking. My aunt has had two micro Bs for her phone, to charge her phone, you know, plugs in the wall and whatnot, both broke. I've had two for my tablet here, both broke. So, I didn't just get one of these. I got 10 of these. And they come with a lifetime warranty, so I should always have one on hand now. I got this because I'm basically mega paranoid about this particular USB type. This is the one my aunt's been using, and they come in some really neat colors, too. But, you know, color isn't as important as functionality, but I figured I would show off the colors as well, just as long as they're all so pretty and whatnot. These are made by Eversame, by the way. I got them from Amazon, and they got really good reviews overall, so I'm hoping that I'll never have to use the warranty, and I'm hoping that they won't regret giving these a lifetime warranty because they keep breaking. I looked up the issue of them breaking, and apparently it is an issue with the design of Micro B. In that it tends to either push in, like the tip of it pushes in, or it breaks near here, like around in this area, because the wiring's kind of small by necessity or whatnot. So yeah, that's why I got a bunch of cables here, because I'm tired of these things breaking and I'm tired of not having any on hand. The next thing is the KDLINKS converter thingy here. Yeah, it converts USB. This is for my aunt, so that she can plug in her phone into said wall. It's got four ports, and yeah, it's just a basic converter. Works well, can't complain. The next thing is something that I had to set up before this video. The Butterfox 2DS case. See, I didn't like any of the officially licensed cases that are going around right now for the 2DS. I got a Butterfox one, as you can tell. Well, it can't kind of read. It's got zippers on both sides so that you can, you know, flip and whatnot. Yeah, now you can read it. There we go. And there's the Butterfox logo and whatnot. But the reason why I didn't like the other licensed 2DS cases is because it's very, I don't know, storage limited, I guess you could say. I don't know why they are super storage limited, but this one is not in the first pockets. We have little elastic straps to keep your 2DS all nice and snug like a bug in a rug, and a soft material to make sure that it doesn't get all scratched and whatnot. I don't think you really have to use the straps if you don't want to use them. You could probably just do that and then flip it over like that and zip it in, but, you know, the straps are added protection from it flying out of there or something, in case you open it, I don't know, upside down or something by mistake. So yeah, just they're there if you would like to use them, basically. And next pocket is the storage that I was looking for. Yes, 12 slots for DS, well, 3DS games. And on the other side, there is a mesh netting pocket, which I'm currently using to host the Kid Icarus Uprising stand thingy here, because it just fits in so nicely. I think it was intended for like a charger or whatnot, but you can put whatever you want in here, because it's all stretchy and stuff like that. I could even see you putting extra games in here if you would like to, you know, as long as you get them in a way that they don't bang against each other, similar to how they are in this pocket right here. And oh yeah, these are elasticy, so you could probably fit two games in each of these pockets. Yeah, that's what I thought, but I just thought I would present them like this, because it's just much, much fancier to show it this way. And as I said about the two zippered compartment thingy here, so you have different ways to unzip said thing. Like, you could either have them just one zip through the whole thing, or just put two zippers right in the center and then split them apart like so to open it up, and yeah. But anyway, it's a very, very nice case. Got great reviews. In fact, all the other stuff that I've shown already got great reviews, which is why I got the stuff, because I'm always trying to make sure that I get the best stuff that I possibly can get so they don't break, like the micro USB cables. But then again, the cables that I got before were, I mean, they had good reviews, but they still failed. They still failed. But enough with the cables, I got some other stuff. The next thing is a delightfully soft Egyptian cotton towel that is... Wait, what? What the heck's it? Yes, PkGam did indeed get Majora's Mask 3D. Well, it's not a uneducated purchase, let me just tell you that. I mean, if this was like the original Majora's Mask, I would not have gotten it. But from what I've seen in reviews and previews and stuff like that, they greatly improved on Majora's Mask. And from what I played, I definitely can tell it's a lot more polished than the original, which they rushed out in a year. And this was in development for over 3 years, if you didn't know that. So yeah, this is apparently more of a game that the designers intended Majora's Mask to be, rather than the one it turned out to be on the N64, so it's closer to the designer's vision. So if you didn't like Majora's Mask on the N64, Wii, or GameCube, you might very well like this one, because they did indeed do a great amount of improvements on it. I've played up to Woodfall so far, and everything seems a ton more polished, so I'm enjoying it a lot more than I did the original Majora's Mask. I also got a guide for this by Prima, but it hasn't come in yet. It's going to come in 3 days later. It's kind of weird how this worked out. The shipments were I had two separate orders. The one with the tech stuff, like the cables, the wall outlet converter, and the case for the 2DS, and then I had game stuff, which was this game and the Prima's official player's guide thing. I got the paperback, not the hardback version. But anyway, they decided to combine everything into one shipment, except for said player's guide for some reason. I don't know why they did that. It might have been because they wanted to protect the player's guide. That's why they put it separate, but it ended up delaying it for, I shouldn't say delaying it. It's actually coming here sooner than they estimated. In fact, all this stuff came in sooner than estimated. It was supposed to come in on the, 19th through the 21st. Like, that was the initial estimated date, but it ended up coming on the 15th, and that's with free shipping, too. So, I got as speedy shipping for stuff that I ordered. You know, this game came out on the 13th, Friday the 13th, get it? You know, it's kind of they probably did that on purpose. So since this all came on the same day, this was shipped out and got to me in 2 days, you know, well, actually 3 days, 13, 14, 15, but it came early on the 15th. But the guide's coming separate on the 18th, though, and that was also estimated to be 3 days later than the rest of the stuff for some reason. I don't know why, but it's okay. I don't mind that at all, because I don't need the guide right away. There's stuff like the Sheikah Stone, and I'm already pretty experienced with Majora's Mask, as you know, so I don't think I'm gonna get lost in the few days that I'm not gonna have a guide. So, yeah, that is the stuff that I got, and no, I didn't actually get an Egyptian cotton towel. This is just a old kitchen towel. I just picked that just because it's fluffy and it would cover the shape of a box. So, yeah, I hope you enjoy, and I will see you later.